Thank you. is giving a ball.
The prince is giving a ball. The prince is giving a ball.
His Royal Highness,
oh!
Christopher Rupert,
no!
Windermere, Vladimir, Carl Alexander, Francois Reginald, Lancelot Herman.
Herman
Gregory James is giving a ball.
The prince is giving a ball. The prince is giving a ball.
Our daughter's looking dreamy-eyed.
The prince is giving a ball. They say he wants to find a bread and learn to make the ball. If only he proposed to me.
I pray that he'll propose to me.
Why should he propose to me?
Son of Her Majesty, Queen Constantina, Charlotte Ermentrude, Guinevere, Maisie.
Maisie,
Marguerite Tad is giving a ball.
The prince is giving a ball. The prince is giving a ball.
I wish I didn't like to eat. I wish I were demure and sweet.
The prince is giving a ball. The prince is giving a ball.
for this evening.
Cinderella, wash my gloves for tomorrow.
Cinderella, it's freezing!
Cinderella, poke the fire!
Cinderella, close the window!
Really, Cinderella?
Cinderella, really?
It's freezing!
Close the window!
Close the window!
Close the window, Cinderella! Now, my daughters, I want to talk to you. Well, not you. I want to talk to my own daughters.
That girl always wants to sit down. No wonder she never gets anything done.
Now, Joy.
Yes, ma'am.
And Portia.
Yes, ma'am.
As you well know, my little moppets. This may be the most important year of your lives. The prince has returned from his studies abroad, and this ball that's being given in his honor is for one purpose only. Every girl in the kingdom wants to marry a prince, including you, Portia.
Uh-huh.
And you, Joy.
Uh-huh.
On our shopping tour today, I bought the most beautiful materials and all the frills and frou-frou my purse could afford. So, whether or not you marry the prince, you'll both be married by this year.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, there's one thing you must remember. When you want to marry a man, you can't rely on your beauty alone. Now, Portia, you are named for a great lawyer.
Uh-huh.
I want you to show off your intellect as well as your beauty. Do you understand?
Naturally. Wow!
Oh! And Joy, I want you to live up to your name. I want you to be vivacious and alert as well as beautiful.
Uh-huh.
That does not mean, however, I want you to neglect your beauty. Our family has always been noted for its fascinating women. So let's all go upstairs and get our beauty sleep. I'm exhausted from all that shopping. Tomorrow I'm going to have to get a good massage. That's the only thing that does me any good. A good pounding. That's what your father used to say.
I'm all tired out too, Ma, going from store to store the way we did.
You're tired.
Yes, I'm tired.
I suppose you think you're the only one that's tired.
I suppose you think you're the only one tired. Well, who wants the
mess?
Gaping at me. Tidy up those tea things.
Yes, ma'am. I wonder why they're so tired looking at all those beautiful things and buying so many of them. I was too excited to be tired. Oh, I love this room when they've all gone out and there's nobody here but me.
Cinderella!
Yes, ma'am?
Stop jumping around down there. We can't sleep for the racket.
Yes, ma'am. Mouse. When I hear a command, I obey. But I know of a spot in my house where no one can stand in my way. In my own little corner, in my own little chair, I can be whatever I want to be. To me, I'm a young Norwegian princess or a milkmaid. I'm the greatest prima donna in the land. I'm an heiress who has always had her silk made by her own flock of silkworms in Japan. I'm a girl men go mad for, love's a game I can play with a cool and confident kind of air. safari. It's a dangerous type of sport, and yet it's fun. In the night, I sally forth to seek my quarry. Then I find I forgot to bring my gun. I am lost in the jungle all alone and unarmed when I meet a lioness in her lair. Oh, then I'm glad to be back in my own little corner, all alone in my own little chair.
The prince is giving a ball. You got us into this.
We had to do something to celebrate the 21st birthday of our son, His Royal Highness
Maisie.
Christopher Rupert.
Maisie.
When the man Vladimir.
Maisie, I know all his names. I'm his father.
A fine father you are.
What do you mean, a fine father you are?
I mean you never worry about him.
Why should I worry about him?
Because he isn't happy.
How do you know?
He doesn't seem to have any interest in anything or anyone.
Oh, he's happy, all right.
If he's happy, why doesn't he get married?
If he's happy, why should he get married?
Look at your pants.
How could I have gained so much weight in 5 years?
Because that's all you've done for 5 years, gained weight. You haven't worn a court costume because we haven't been a ball in 5 years. You've done nothing to give your subjects any fun. Not a festival, not a fair, not a pageant. You've done nothing to make your people love you.
But they do anyway, don't they? Oh.
The royal tailor will have to make you another suit.
That'll cost money.
Don't start to worry about what you're gonna have to pay the tailor. Worry about how much this ball is going to cost.
Maisie! Now's not the time to splurge. The exchequer is very low, and I can't afford...
I have a chef and a steward outside waiting to report their plans for the dinner.
The dinner?
Certainly, you can't give a ball without a dinner. Come in, gentlemen.
Don't have them in here.
Your Majesties,
Your Majesties,
a list of the bare necessities, a list of the bare necessities for what?
For 1,700 guests.
That seems a lot. Don't have any king crab. I hate to see that on a menu. King crab, it seems as a comment on my disposition.
1,000 baby lobsters for the salad.
Wow!
And 500 pheasants for the pie.
Aye, aye! 1,000!
Hush!
It's more than the sturgeon can supply. I told the steward to get us 40 acres of lettuce and 600 suckling pigs for roasting! What about the marshmallows?
Who wants marshmallows?
I do.
Why?
For toasting. Now, if it please your majesties, I have a list of wine. The best of all the vintages from every nation's vine. I want the wine of my country.
Hush, hush, hush.
Sherry and port and muscatel, Kibble and Ardouvée, dry champagne and sweet moselle, Burgundy and Chablis, aquavit and Liffremilk, hock and chocolate molten milk, brandy, drambuie and vodka, white and crystal clear. I want the wine of my country. I want the wine of my country. I want the wine of my country. The wine of my country is beer.
Obviously.
Now, your majesties, about that list of wine, which...
Oh, they're so beautiful.
$200.
It's an import.
You better hope that's on sale.
Oh,
it's too shiny.
Oh, but no, it isn't.
Roasting.
No marshmallows.
Oh, Garland, Gucci, I love Garland! We are having marshmallows!
Oh, we're not!
It's so fun to roast over an open fire!
Oh, you're so mature!
$1,000?! I've never seen a cake that costs $1,000 before! To the ball!
The ball!
Of sunrise, when the deep purple heaven turns blue, and start to pray as I pray each day that I'll hear some word from you. I lie in the loneliness of evening, looking out on a silver-flaked sea, and ask the moon, oh, how soon will my love appear to me? I ask the moon, oh, how soon will my love appear to me?
Father.
Hello, my boy. Thought you were going for a ride.
I am, sir. The groom is bringing my horse around at 3 o'clock.
Christopher, are you feeling all right?
Fine, Father.
Not unhappy or anything, are you?
Why, no, Father.
That's what I thought. Oh, that's fine.
It seems to me, sir, that you look a little tired.
I am tired when I think about that darn ball. You know that ball you're giving with my money?
Oh, that. Well... To tell you the truth, sir, it isn't a night I'm looking forward to. Dancing with all those candidates.
Candidates?
Every simpering girl in the kingdom, each one determined to show that she would be the perfect princess for me.
Well, I know how you feel. More fun to chase one girl than be stampeded by a whole herd of them.
One thing is sure, whoever I marry, it won't be anyone I meet at the ball.
Know how you feel, my boy. I'd feel the same, only there's one thing we mustn't forget. Your mother's got her heart set on giving this affair.
Yes, I know.
Christopher, if you talk to your mother about this, don't let her know how you really feel. Tell her that you love the idea of the ball. Make her feel good about it. Know what I mean? Ah, all right. Now I'll tell you. Hello, my dear. We, Christopher and I, were just...
I was just saying, Mother, how much I'm looking forward to the ball. It sounds wonderful.
Does it?
Yes. I was wondering if I could help you at all. I mean, in any of the preparations?
Well, yes, dear, maybe you can.
And I see they're bringing my horse around from the stables now.
Well, have you got the sniffles?
No.
Well, getting a cold?
No.
Well, better take something for it. Don't want to have a red nose at the ball.
I'll be over it by then.
Maisie?
What?
That boy isn't unhappy, you know.
How do you know?
I asked him. He says he's feeling fine.
Did he?
Mm-hmm.
You know something?
What?
I love you.
Naturally you do. I'm the king.
Nothing to do with it. Boys and girls like you and me walk beneath the skies. They love just as we love with the same dream in their eyes. Songs and kings and many things have the day and are gone. But boys and girls like you and me, we go on and on.
They walk on every village street. They walk in lanes where branches meet, and stars send down their blessings from the blue.
They go through storms of doubt and fear, and so they go from year to year, believing in each other as we do.
Bravely marching forward two by two. Boys and girls like you and me walk beneath the skies. They love just as we love,
the same dream in their eyes.
Songs and kings and many things have their day and are gone. But boys and girls like you and me, we go on and on.
A holiday is hereby declared. Let every shop be closed. Let every bank be closed. Let every school be closed. For today is the day of the ball.
chair. I can be whatever I want to be. On the wing of my fancy, I can fly anywhere, and the world will open its arms to me. I am in the royal palace of all places. I am chatting with the prince and king and queen, and the color on my two-step sister's faces is a queer sort of sour apple green. I am coy and flirtatious when alone with the prince. Oh la, your highness, you shouldn't say such things.
You can go somewhere else and be paid.
You mean leave my stepmother? I don't think if Father were alive, he would like that.
If your father saw how your stepmother treated you, I'm sure he wouldn't mind. Aren't you going to offer me some tea?
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. I'll just light the fire. But it was out! And the kettle's hot! It's most curious. Oh, flowers! Oh, but I'm sure you brought them, didn't you?
I thought they'd brighten your room. Your water's boiling.
Oh, please have a seat. I'll have this in a minute.
Thank you.
You know, I'm so awfully glad you happened to come by tonight. I was getting very lonely.
I thought you might be.
Godmother, do dreams never, never come true?
Oh, I wouldn't say never, just seldom.
That's not very often, is it?
Not very often is precisely what seldom is. You're a nice godchild, but you ask very foolish questions.
I wish you believed in wonderful things. I wish you believed that once in a while, something marvelous and magical could happen.
Well, I can't say that I don't believe that every once in a while, something marvelous and magical can't happen.
For instance, do you believe in guardian angels?
Well, I can't say I don't believe in them. Only thing is, it's dangerous to leave too much in good fairies and guardian angels.
Why?
Oh, you get to lean on them too much. You get in the habit of sitting back and expecting them to do all the work for you. You have to help yourself, you know.
I know. I think about it a lot. But then I don't know what to do. And so I always wind up just wishing and dreaming. I suppose that doesn't do any good at all.
Well, I can't say it doesn't do any good at all. As a matter of fact, everything starts with a wish. Nothing happens without wishing.
Do you know what I was wishing tonight, just before you came?
I'm almost afraid to hear.
Do you see that pumpkin out in the yard?
I nearly stumbled over it in the dark.
The moon is shining on it now. Well, I was wishing that pumpkin would turn into a great, big, royal golden carriage that would take me to the ball tonight.
And what were you going to do for horses?
Oh, white mice. Four white mice to turn to horses. Beautiful white prancing steeds.
Were you going to drive them yourself?
Oh, no. There'd be a coachman and a footman and two flunkies on the back seat.
Where were they coming from?
They could be the four puppies I saw down the cell yesterday. Oh, I know what you're going to say. Fal-de-rol and fiddly-dee.
Yes, fal-de-rol and fiddly-dee.
It's impossible, I suppose.
Impossible.
Just the same, it was what I was wishing, and I'm still wishing it.
Nonsense.
I'm wishing it very hard.
You are?
Yes, I am. If only I could have some magical help. If only I had a guardian angel. Or if my godmother were a fairy godmother.
Good joke. Very funny.
I'm wishing in the name of every young girl who ever wanted to go to a dance and was told she couldn't. I am wishing that I might go to that dance tonight. I wish that by some kind of magic or abracadabra or fol-de-rol and fiddly-dee. All the kind hearts in the world will put their heads together.
All the kind hearts put their heads together.
You know what I mean. That all the kind hearts and good souls will wish with me. And that you, Godmother, will help me in every ounce and strength of cleverness you possess.
Cinderella.
Yes, Godmother?
It's impossible.
Impossible. I suppose so.
Impossible. For a plain yellow pumpkin to become a golden carriage, impossible. For a plain country bumpkin and a prince to join in marriage, and four white mice will never be four white horses. Such fol-de-rol and fiddle-dee-dee, of course, is impossible. But the world is full of zanies and fools who don't believe in won't believe what sensible people say. And because these soft and dewy-eyed dopes keep building up impossible hopes, impossible things are happening every day. Impossible.
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 So, in a way.
Then I continue to build up my impossible hope for tonight, and I officially wish.
Officially wish?
I officially wish, and wish all those things I said about the pumpkin, and the mice, and the puppies.
Impossible.
Just the same, I'm wishing it.
Impossible for a plain yellow pumpkin to become a golden carriage. Impossible. For a plain country bumpkin and a prince to join in marriage, and four white mice will never be four white horses.
They will.
Such fol-de-rol and fiddle-dee-dee, of course, is impossible.
But the world is full of zanies and fools who won't believe in sensible rules and won't believe what sensible people say.
Thank you. it's magic.
But I don't understand.
And you don't have to. If you don't hurry, the ball will be over before you get there.
Aren't you coming with me?
Heavens no. I've been to so many of these things, I couldn't stand another. Furthermore, all I can do is give you your wish. How it turns out from here is up to you.
But I'm afraid to go there all by myself.
You needn't be, except for one thing. Do not stay beyond 12 o'clock. See that you're in the coach and off for home before the clock strikes 12.
Why is it so important that I leave before 12?
You just obey and don't ask any questions.
But Godmother, where are you? Where did she go? She just vanished out of sight. Did you ever see anything like that before?
Many times.
It's the first time I've seen it happen.
Well, you'll see worse if you're not out of here by 12 o'clock.
I'm ready.
Much to tell. I slayed a few dragons, rescued a few princesses, outwitted a few magicians, the usual thing.
Whoa! From heaven!
You know, watching him dance with that lovely creature, it takes me back.
To where?
To the first time I danced with you, my darling.
I wonder who she is.
I wonder who she is.
Who is she? I never saw the girl before.
Well, whoever she is, it's clear he likes her best.
Funny, she doesn't look very intellectual.
Ladies and gentlemen, King Maximilian and Queen Maisie request your presence in the Royal Banquet Hall for refreshments.
Never met you before, have I?
No, I don't get out much.
I don't even know your name. Mine is Christopher.
Oh, yes, I know. Christopher Rupert Windermere Vladimir.
I don't use all those names. I would like you to call me just Christopher.
You would?
Have you a strange feeling that something has just happened to you and you don't know what it is?
Yes, that's exactly the way I feel.
And you have no idea what it may be?
No, I have no idea. I wonder how we can find out what it is.
Let us think back over our history together.
It isn't very long, is it?
10 minutes ago, I saw you. I looked up when you came through the door. My head started reeling. You gave me the feeling the room had no ceiling or floor. 10 minutes ago, I met you. And we murmured our how do you do's. I wanted to ring out the bells and fling out my arms and to sing out the news. I have found her, she's an angel with the dust of the stars in her eyes. We are dancing, we are flying, and she's taking mountain and meadow and glen, and I like it so well that for all I can tell, I may never come down again. I may never come down to earth again.
I've told you how I felt. You haven't described your feelings.
Well, they're very much the same as yours. 10 minutes ago, I met you, and we murmured our how do you do's. I wanted to ring out the bells and fling out my arms and to sing out the news. I have found him, I have found him.
popular bubble with loose of air. And with a little trouble, I can pull out a hair.
Ow! Ow!
I would not want a girl like her, so obviously unusual. Why can the fellow ever want sweeper? A usual girl like me. What's the matter with the man? What's the matter with the man? What's the matter with the man?
The prince is a lucky man.
Oh, she's very attractive.
Oh, yes, she is.
Oh, no, she is.
Thank you.
The ballroom is too crowded.
It's nice out here.
Yes, it is, with the moon beaming down on us.
Oh.
What's the matter?
I must go.
Why?
Because I promised my godmother.
Your godmother will forgive you if you're a little late.
Oh, no, she won't. You don't understand. I have a strange kind of godmother.
You're a strange kind of girl. You haven't yet told me your name.
Oh, it's a silly name. You wouldn't like it.
Whatever you're called is the most beautiful name in the world. Whatever your name is, I love you. I will always love you. You don't say anything. I have just told you that I love you, and you don't say anything.
I'm afraid to. I'm afraid I might wake up.
Are you sure that you're asleep?
Oh, yes.
Are you dreaming that I'm about to kiss you? It's strange how things happen. A girl I never saw before comes into a room, and my whole life is changed. Suddenly, I am in a different world. I am deeply in love, and yet, I don't know why. Do you?
Do I what?
Do you know why I'm in love? What did you think I meant?
I thought you meant, do I know why I am in love?
Well, do you? I mean, are you?
Oh, yes.
And do you know why?
No. But I don't care why.
I always want to know why I do anything, why I feel anything. And so, I ask myself, why you, a stranger, are suddenly the only kind of girl I could ever love. And you are the only one of your kind. Why? Why is the sound of your voice the sweetest sound in the world? Why is the color of your hair the only color a girl's hair should be? Why would I rather hold you in my arms than do anything else in the world? Why?
Because, Your Highness.
Christopher.
Christopher, because that's the way you feel.
But why do I feel that way? What makes you so miraculous?
Your imagination.
Then what makes my imagination so miraculous? Do I love you because you're beautiful? Or are you beautiful because I love you? Am I making believe I see in you a girl too lovely to be really true? Do I want you because you're wonderful? Or are you wonderful because I want you? Are you the sweet invention of a lover's dream? Or are you really as wonderful as you seem?
Maybe you do just imagine me. Maybe I'm imagining you. I cannot believe this is happening to me, that I'm here with you and that you really love me. Am I making believe I see in you a man too perfect to be really true? Do I want you because you're wonderful, or are you wonderful because I want you?
Are you the sweet invention of a lover's dream? Or are you really as wonderful as you seem?
The clock! Oh!
Even know your name.
Affair.
Were there many people there?
Oh, I should say about 5,000. What would you say, girls?
Oh, I would say about 10,000
or 12.
It must be a very large ballroom at the palace.
About a half a mile long.
And what beautiful music for dancing.
Did you dance too?
I should say I did. I met old boo of mine and he practically monopolized me.
Was he a good dancer?
Light as a feather.
Did any of you get to dance with the prince?
Did any of us get to dance with the prince?
Didn't you hear what she said? Did we dance? I danced about an hour with him.
You danced about an hour with him.
Didn't you?
Well, of course I did. You did.
Girls!
Did you know everyone there?
Nearly everyone. All except a princess who came very late and left very early. I had no idea who she was.
Did she dance with the prince?
Yes, I think I saw her dancing with him once.
That's right, just once.
Do you think he liked her?
Yeah.
She was only there for a few minutes.
Did you go to sleep right after we left?
No, I stayed up till a little after midnight.
What were you doing all that time?
Oh, dreaming.
Dreaming what?
What it must be like at the ball.
Well, you couldn't possibly dream what it was like unless you were really there.
Well, I was trying to.
Well, you just couldn't.
Well, maybe I have more imagination than you think. I've been dreaming and trying to feel just the way you must feel. The way all girls must be feeling. Looking forward to the ball all that time. And finally the night arrives. And you put on the most beautiful dress you've ever worn in your life. And off you go. I think I can almost feel what it's like. I imagine. When you're driving through the moonlight on the highway, when you're driving through the moonlight to the dance, you are breathless with a wild anticipation of adventure and excitement and romance. Then at last you see the towers of the palace silhouetted on the sky above the park, and below them is a row of lighted windows like a lovely diamond necklace in the dark.
It looks that way,
the way you say
she talks as if she knows.
I do not know, these things are so, I only just suppose. I suppose that when you come into the ballroom and the room itself is floating in the air, if you're suddenly confronted by His Highness, you are frozen like a statue on the stair. You're afraid He'll hear the way your heart is beating. Oh, and you know you mustn't make the first advance. You are seriously thinking of retreating. Then you seem to hear Him asking you to dance. You make a bow, a timid bow, and shyly answer yes.
How would you know that this is so?
I do no more than guess.
You can guess till you're blue in the face, but you can't even picture such a man. He's more than the prince, he's an ace.
But sisters, I really think I can.
And what?
I think that I can picture such a man.
He is tall
and straight as a lance,
and his hair
is dark and wavy,
his eyes,
and loves you with a glance.
He can turn a girl to gravy.
When he waltzes, he whirls you around so that your feet never touch the floor.
That's right, they don't.
He makes you feel as if you weigh nothing at all.
That's right, he does.
He leads you around the ballroom and out onto the terrace.
That's right.
He did.
Didn't he lead you onto the terrace?
I guess he did. I was so faint with joy. I didn't know what happened to you.
Me too.
Out on the terrace, he stopped dancing.
Yes.
You walk.
Yes.
You stop walking.
Yes.
You talk. Then
you stop talking.
And that's right.
Then
you start thinking.
Start thinking what?
Oh, how wonderful it all is.
How wonderful what all is?
Oh, everything. A lovely night, a lovely night, a finer night you know you'll never see. You meet your prince, a charming prince, as charming as a prince will ever be. The stars in the hazy heaven tremble of you, while he is whispering, darling, I love you. You say goodbye, away you fly, but on your lips you'll keep a kiss. All your life you'll dream of this lovely, lovely night.
A lovely night, a lovely night.
Your prince, a charming prince,
as charming as a prince will ever be. The stars in a hazy heaven tremble above you,
while he is whispering, darling, I love you.
You say goodbye, away you fly,
but on your lips you keep a kiss. All your life you'll dream of this lovely, lovely night. A lovely night. How lovely. A lovely night. How lovely. A finer night you know you'll never see. How lovely.
You meet your prince,
a charming prince, as charming as a prince will ever be. The stars in a hazy heaven
tremble above you,
while he is whispering, darling, I love you.
What?
Say goodbye, away you fly.
But on your lips you keep a kiss.
All your life you'll dream of this lovely,
lovely, lovely night. Worst nonsense and rubbish I ever heard. And you, even aping on her every word.
stars in the hazy heaven trembled above me, danced while he promised always to love me. The day came through, away I flew, but on my lips I'll keep a kiss. All my life I'll dream of this lovely, lovely night.
Belongs to her.
What are you going to do?
Sir, may I have your royal guards to send throughout the kingdom in search of her?
Of course you may.
And your secret service, may I call them in to help me?
Of course. They never find out anything, but you can try.
I will try everything. I will search every inch of the kingdom for the owner of this slipper.
That's what I would do.
You must try the slipper on every young maiden. Every last one, no matter how unlikely she looks. You are to keep trying until you find the one that fits. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
I must find that girl.
I will just go speak with my chief of secret service.
Chris, come here.
Yes, mother?
Suppose you don't find her.
I must find her.
Before last night, you knew nothing about her. You know nothing about her now except that she danced prettily and she looked pretty.
I know that she's the loveliest thing on earth. And I will never be happy without her.
Why do you think that?
I don't know why. And I don't expect you to understand, Mother.
But I do understand, Chris. I understand that it doesn't take long to feel the way you do about this girl. But there is one fact I want you to face. You may never see her again. And I don't want you to waste your whole life on a dream. I want you to be in love with a real girl.
She is real.
She was real last night. But if she doesn't come back, she may never be real again. Will she? Chris, be honest with yourself. Does your future happiness really depend upon finding her? Or are you just telling yourself that? Don't be angry with me. Think over what I am saying. Ask yourself if this is not just an illusion, an infatuation with something that doesn't exist at all.
You're somewhere out there. I don't know where. You said last night you thought we were dreaming. Maybe you were right. Maybe my mother is right. How can I know? How can one ever know? Do I love you because you're beautiful?
Or is she beautiful because you love her?
Am I making believe I see in you a girl too lovely to be really true? Do I want you because you're wonderful?
Or is she wonderful because you want her?
Are you the sweet invention of a lover? Of the kingdom to the other, I shall seek my bride.
Yeah.
It's time to rest for another day.
I cannot rest until I find you. You may go. Look, there's another cottage in the distance.
Anyone else left in the house?
No, nobody else is here.
Oh, except Cinderella.
Who's Cinderella?
Why, she's just sort of a general helper and chimney sweep here.
I was instructed to try the slipper on everyone. I'll check upstairs.
There's no one there.
No one there? I told you so.
Isn't that just like Cinderella? She hasn't even finished the laundry.
Or the floor.
And someone should really sweep out that chimney.
And you tried the slipper on every young maiden?
Every maiden that could be found. I'm sorry, Your Highness.
Mother was right. I'll never find her. Either she doesn't exist, or she's fled the kingdom. Thank you. You may go.
Excuse me, Your Highness. I didn't think anyone was here. Oh, I'm so sorry.
You look familiar somehow. At least I think you do. I'm sure I've seen you before, or someone who looks like you. Do you by chance have a sister?
Two, Your Highness.
These sisters, were they at the ball?
Yes, Your Highness.
Do they look like you?
Well, they're stepsisters, Your Highness.
Stepsisters? Oh.
Is there anything wrong, Your Highness?
Just the end of a dream. A dream about a glass slipper that didn't fit anyone.
Oh, Your Highness, you mustn't give up hope.
It was all a waste of time, a wild goose chase. It was impossible.
But, Your Highness, impossible things happen every day.
And even foolish dreams come true?
Oh, yes, Your Highness. If you wish hard enough and believe in what you're wishing, even foolish dreams come true.
Why do I feel? Or am I just imagining? Who are you?
Oh, I'm just a girl from the village. I think I'd better go. My stepmother will be wondering where I am.
Your stepmother wouldn't mind if you're a little late.
Really, Your Highness, I must go.
Yes, I suppose you must.
Well, goodbye, Your Highness.
Yes, goodbye. Wait, at least tell me your name.
Oh, it's a silly name. You wouldn't like it.
Silly name? Wouldn't like it? Please tell me your name.
Cinderella!
Cinderella!
Stop. Did anyone try the slipper on you?
No, Your Highness.
For a plain country bumpkin and a prince to join in marriage, and for what?